morning all of you. This is exercise 13B, question number 6. Here in this question it says ABCD is a rhombus. You are given with ABCD as a rhombus. Angle DAC means DAC. It is equal to how much? 50 degree. We have to find out angle ACD, CAB and ABC. For this, we have to see. We are taking a triangle ADC, means this portion. A, B and C. We are taking this triangle ADC. AD is equal to DC. This AD is equal to BC because these are the sides of rhombus, okay? Similarly, DAC is equal to ACD. DAC is equal to ACD. Why? Angle opposite to equal sides are equal. If DAC is 50 degree, ACD will also be 50 degree. So from here we have to find out ACD. DAC is equal to ACD because angle opposite to equal sides are equal. For this, similarly for this, that's why ACD will be equal to 50 degree because these both are angle opposite to equal sides are equal. Similarly, we have to find out angle CAB and angle ABC. For CAB, what we have to see? CAB equal to ACD. CAB, this is equal to ACD. Why? This is also equal to 50 degree because alternate angles, and you know that AB is parallel to CD. AB is parallel to CD. Similarly, CAB is equal to ACB because angle opposite to equal sides are equal. So in triangle, we have to find out angle A plus angle B plus angle C is equal to 180 degree. You know that angle A and angle C are equal, that is 50 degree. So from here, angle A is 50 degree, angle B we have to find out, and again angle C is also 50 degree, that is 180 degree. 50-50 is 100 plus angle B, it is equal to 180 degree. Angle B is equal to 180 degree minus 100 degree. From here, angle B is equal to how much? 80 degree. Or I can say, angle ABC is also equal to how much? 80 degree. So what we did in this question, first we have find out angle ACD, that is equal to 50 degree. Secondly, we have find out angle CAB. You know that CAB is equal to ACD, that is equal to 50 degree. Similarly, here angle CAB, that will also be equal to how much? 50 degree. Okay. And third, we have to find out angle ABC. If angle B is equal to 80 degree, angle ABC is also equal to 80 degree. Question number 7. In this question, it says ABCD is a trapezium in which AB is parallel to BC. This ABCD is a trapezium in which this AB is parallel to BC. Okay? And what is given? Angle A equal to angle B. If angle A is 40 degree, this is equal to angle B, so angle B will also be 40 degree. So from here, what are the values of other two angles? We have to find out angle D and angle C. So let's angle D be X, angle C be X. So in this question, you are given with angle A, angle B, angle A is equal to angle B, that is 40 degree. Both the angles are 40 degree. Your base angles are equal. You can see the bases angle are equal. So in quadrilateral, ABCD is a isosceles quadrilateral. Here it is given A, angle A is equal to angle B, and that is equal to how much? 40 degree. So by angle sum property of a quadrilateral, we can write down as angle A plus angle B plus angle C plus angle D equal to how much? 360 degree. This is by angle sum property of a quadrilateral. Angle sum property of a quadrilateral. Okay, so from here angle A and angle B is given, that is 40 degree plus 40 degree plus angle C plus angle D is equal to how much? 360 degree, okay? So you know, I have taken angle C plus angle D, there is X. So this is X, this is also X. So from here, 40 plus 40 is 80 degree plus 2X is equal to 360 degree. From here, transfer 80 degree. 360 degree minus 80 degree. So 2X is equal to, this 0 minus 0 is 0, 16 minus 8 is 8, and this is 2. So X is equal to 280 degree by 2. So this is 2 1s are 2 4s are 8 and 0. So from here X is equal to how much? 140 degree. X is equal to how much? 140 degree. And you know, angle D is X, that is this is also 140 degree, and angle C is X, so this is also 140 degree. So from here, angle D equal to angle C equal to how much? 140 degree. This is the answer. This is question number 8. This question, it says calculate the angle marked with small letter in the following diagram. Okay, you have to calculate this first portion. It is given for rectangle. ABCD is a rectangle here, and AC and DB are the diagonal of this rectangle. So here, the diagonal of a rectangle are congruent and they bisect each other. Okay, these both the diagonals, they are congruent and they bisect each other at point O. From here, angle OAB. O angle OAB is equal to angle OBA. If angle OAB is equal to 21 degree, OBA will also be equal to 21 degree. Okay, so all interior angle of a rectangle are right angle. You know that all interior angle of a rectangle are right angle. Right angle means it is of 90 degree. So I can write down this angle. I can write down this as 21 degree plus x degree equal to how much? 90 degree, because we know all interior angle of a rectangle are of 90 degree. So from here, x equal to 90 degree minus 21 degree. So x equal to 10 minus 1 is 9, 8 minus 2 is 6, that is 69 degree. Therefore, this angle will be of how much? 69. Same question, and the second diagram is for rectangle. You are given with a rectangle PQRS, okay, where PR and QS are the diagonals and they intersect at point O. Here you are given with angle O, that is 102 degree, and angle B and angle E you have to find out. So for this, you know angle ORS is equal to OSR. ORS is equal to OSR. If this is angle B, so this will also be angle B. Okay. So here, this is angle B. Similarly, ROS is equal to POQ. ROS equal to POQ. These are which angles? These are vertical angles. So I can write down this. These are vertical angles. So from angle sum theory, I can write down what this angle sum theory says. It is equal to the sum of the angles are equal to how much by? This is by angle sum property. This is by angle sum property. So you by angle sum theory. Here by angle sum theory, angle POQ plus angle ORS plus angle OSR equal to how much? 180 degree. This you are given with 102 degree. OSR is equal to B, and ORS is also B degree, and angle OSR is also B degree. So that is equal to 180 degree. From here, 102 degree plus B plus B is 2B equal to how much? 180 degree. From here, 2B equal to 180 degree minus 102 degree. So B here, B will be equal to 10 minus 2 is 8, 7, 10 minus 2 is 8, this is 7, and here it will be, that is 78 degree. Angle B is equal to how much? That is equal to 78 degree. This is 2B na. So from here, B equal to 78 by 2. 2 1 jar, 3 jar 6, 2 9 jar 18. So from here, angle B is equal to how much? 39 degree. So here angle B is equal to how much? 39 degree. Okay. Similarly, we have to find out angle A. So for finding out angle A, you know that if I write angle A plus angle B is equal to how much? 90 degree. I am given with angle B. So B is 39 degree. I can easily find out angle A. That is A is equal to 90 degree minus 39 degree. So angle A is equal to 10 minus 9 is 1. Again 8 minus 3 is 551 degree. Angle A will be equal to 51 degree and angle B will be equal to 39 degree. This is 51 degree. This is question number 8, third part, and you are given with a rhombus PQRS. You know that diagonal of a rhombus are perpendicular bisector. You know these diagonals SQ and PR, they are perpendicular bisector. So from here angle LP and Q is equal to 90 degree. You know why? This is by the definition of rhombus. Okay. So from here angle PLQ plus angle LPQ plus angle LQP. Okay. This is equal to 180 degree. This is by angle sum property. This is by angle sum property. So from here, angle PLQ is how much? 90 degree. Here it is given. Angle LPQ it is given 34 degree. And angle LQP we have taken X degree. And it is equal to 180 degree by angle sum property. So from here, if I have to take out the value of X, what I have to do? This is 124 degree plus x equal to how much? 180 degree. X equal to 180 degree minus 124 degree. So from here 10 minus 4 is 6, 7 minus 2 is 5, 1 minus 1 is 0. So from here x is equal to 56 degree. So you know that angle Q is equal to how much? 56 degree. Angle PQS is equal to how much? 56 degree. And this is equal to angle PSQ. This will also be equal to 56 degree. So from here, if angle X is equal to 56 degree, angle Y will also be equal to 56 degree. Question, diagonals were given and they were perpendicular bisector. Angle PLQ is how much? 90 degree, because it is by the definition of rhombus. You will get from here all the values are given. To substitute the value, you will get the value of X, and you know that angle PQS is equal to angle PSQ. If angle PQS is equal to 50 degree, this will also be 50 degree. Why this will be 50 degree? Because these are by the property of isosceles triangle. Property of isosceles triangle. From here, if x is equal to 50 degrees, similarly y will also be equal to 50 degrees. 56 degree. X is equal to 56 degrees, and y will also be equal to 56 degrees. This is the answer. This is question number 13. If the diagonal of a rhombus are 12 cm and 16 cm, find the length of each side. And you know this is a, suppose this is a rhombus. And these two diagonals, they intersect each other, okay? So what is given? Diagonal 1 and diagonals are given. So if I take given, diagonals are given. Suppose I write diagonal D1, that is 12 cm, and diagonal D2, that is equal to 16 cm. So half of both the diagonals will be, this will be 12 by 2, this is 6 cm, and similarly this will be 16 by 2, that is 8 centimeter. Okay, so you know in a rhombus all the angles are of 90 degree. The diagonal they bisect each angle in a rhombus, the diagonal bisect each other at 90 degree. So by Pythagoras, I can apply Pythagoras theorem here. So this will be equal to 8 square plus 6 square will be equal to how much? Hypotenuse square. 64 plus 6 square is 36, that is equal to x square. Okay, then this will be equal to 6 plus 4 is 10, again 10, 100, this will be hypotenuse square. So from here hypotenuse will be equal to root over 100, or you can write down this as 10 square, this and this will get cancelled, hypotenuse will be equal to